Hello everyone, welcome to lesson 64 of our Golang course. In this lesson, we will cover ServeMux. Please note that we will use Go 1.22 for this lesson as ServeMux has received some major updates, which means you probably don't need to use any of the third-party packages for your routing needs. Let us discuss ServeMux in detail now. Let us start with a quick overview of ServeMux. If you have worked with other languages to create HTTP server and configure routes, ServeMux is similar to routers in other languages. ServeMux is an HTTP request multiplexer. A request multiplexer allows you to match different request handlers to different URLs served by your server. ServeMux will use a list of register patterns and call the respective handlers that most closely match the pattern of the URL. Patterns are the URL patterns that ServeMux will accept. In the most general form, the pattern looks something like this. So it is a string where you specify a method, space, the host, and the path. Let us go over a few examples to get a better understanding of working with patterns. Here, the pattern /hello matches the path /hello for any host and method, since we are not specifying a method in the pattern. Pattern get/hello matches only a GET request made to the path, that is /hello. Next, we have a pattern get/hello/, which matches only GET request for all paths that begin with /hello/. Then we have the pattern with the wildcard, pattern get/hello, and then the wildcard, which is user_id message. This will match the path with segment hello, while the user ID denotes the path param or a wildcard to match. Let us explore a little more about wildcard. The wildcard in the path that we saw earlier with user_id matches only a single path segment till the next forward slash. So, for example, a GET request made to server address, then the path, then 1/ the message will match the pattern get/hello and the wildcard for user ID and then the message. The user ID wildcard will match 1 in this case. You can use the path value method on the request to get this value. Please note that if the wildcard ends with ellipsis, then it matches the rest of the URL. Ellipsis wildcard is only allowed at the end of the URL. For example, get/hello/user ID then followed by ellipsis. In this case, the path value user_id will be the rest of the URL after hello, or whatever you provide here. A special wildcard, which is the $, matches only the end of the URL. For example, if we have the path pattern $, it only matches /, whereas if we would have supplied a pattern just /, it would have matched every path. You can read more about wildcards and path patterns in the ServeMux documentation. I will provide a link to this in the video description. If two or more patterns match a request, then the most specific pattern takes precedence. So make sure that you design your API paths in a way that they are clear and conflict-free. As an example, the general rule is that here /hello/there/ is more specific than hello/. So both can be registered, but in this case, this URL here is more specific. So the former matches the path beginning with hello/there/, while the later will match any path that is starting with hello/, or the whole subtree. With that covered, let us write our program to have multiple routes configured with ServeMux. So in here, let us create a router with ServeMux, HTTP, new ServeMux. Then let us just start our server. If error is equal to http://listen-and-serve. Provide the address, which is 8080, and then router. If error not is equal to nil, write the error to the console with fmt println supplying the error. You can see here that router is of type ServeMux, but it satisfies the handler interface, which is why we were able to supply it in listen and serve. Now let us start configuring our handlers with route patterns. router.handle function. I am using handler func. So we can first supply the pattern get/hello and then our handle func, which is a closure which accepts a response writer and a request body. In response, w.write hello. So that's one route configured for our server. Next, let us configure one with a wildcard. Router handle func player post forward slash hello, and then configure the wildcard, which is user underscore ID, supply the handle func. And in here, we can do user ID getit using the path value. On the request, provide the wildcard, which is user underscore ID, and then write a hello response. Now, we have configured two routes for our server with help of ServeMux. First one is get forward slash hello. The other one is a post route hello slash wildcard user ID. That's basically how you can use the ServeMux to configure a router. You can configure any number of routes as you would like, and then supply the handler func handling the request in the function body. Let us now run our program. So we don't see any error. Our server is running. Now let us make a curl request to our hello route. And as you can see, we were able to get a response. If I do hello 123, this is not allowed. As you can see, we are getting method not allowed because we have configured this route or the path only to accept post requests. So if I change it to post, you will see that we are getting hello 123, which is the user ID we supplied in the path. So that's basically how you can use ServeMux to configure different route patterns along with their handlers. We will use this when we do a project to build a RESTful API. That's it for the lesson. Let us summarize everything we have learned. So in this lesson, we saw that with Go 122, a lot of changes has been made to ServeMux, introducing more feature-rich capabilities. One of them is allowing extensive pattern matching, making the need of using third-party routers redundant. That's it for the lesson. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions, please feel free to ask in the comment section below or reach out to the Discord server. Until next time, happy coding!